Well, welcome everybody to this magnificent Barony Hall and to a very special occasion. Today we are going to cap our graduands, who will then become graduates, an ancient tradition reaching back to the Scottish Enlightenment, which shows the rite of passage for students as they undergo their university education. As we go through that process, we will bring our students up onto the stage. I will cap them. They will then return back to the stage to much applause. So please do show your appreciation for your family, for your loved ones, for the students who are graduating today. It's a really big occasion, and we encourage you to get involved and to be vociferous and applaud as much as you possibly can. Strathclyde was originally founded in the Enlightenment. The Barony Hall is a magnificent testament to our progress across the ages, and we look forward to our graduation ceremony today and graduating our students. After the ceremony, or after the capping, I should say, I'll say a few short words-ish about the university, and then we'll have a procession from the Barony Hall up to the Teaching and Learning Building, where we'll have a reception to celebrate with our students and enjoy some refreshments. But for now, I formally declare this ceremony open.
In the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for Research in the Department of Strathclyde Institute of Pharmacy and Biomedical Sciences, Reem Kashim N. Al-Qahtani. Sana Behrens. Charles Begley. Adriana Bazior. Eleanor Michelle Brammer. Rachel Georgina Craig. Lloyd Robert John Farker. Eleanor Catherine Lade Jones. Corin Mack. John Mahon. Julian David Phipps. Vishal Raval. Dong Sha. For the degree of Master of Philosophy for Research in the Department of Strathclyde Institute of Pharmacy and Biomedical Sciences, Asmina Mather. For the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Clinical Pharmacy Practice, Fiona Jane Ingram. Ewan McLean. Lorena Maria Moran. In Clinical Pharmacy, Sheikha Alazemi. In Neuroscience and Mental Health, Yuhan Chung. For the degree of Master in Science in Biochemistry, Sabrina Lau. Gailash Ruthie Rakkumar. James Miles Wood. In immunology, Simeon Gerasimou. Nicole Ann Ticcioni. In microbiology, Kirsten Beattie. Kate Jan MacDonald. In pharmacology, Ayaz Ahmad. Mirren Cameron Ruiz. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Biochemistry and Immunology, Lucy Patricia Arlo. Molly Alexander. Leah Smith. In biochemistry and microbiology, Leah Ashby. Nora Novak. Elysius Jasmine Wilson. In biochemistry and pharmacology, Paula Bartosztyk. Joanna Vaskova Borisova. Marcella Carmen Bota. Erin Lorraine Davidson. Shushan Liu. Tian Shu Ku. Karis Alana Robertson. Katrina May Temple Atkinson. Alana May Templeton. Rhys Thompson. Lu Wei Wu. Xu Yang Shu. Sarah Berry. Sophie Margaret Coutts. Brooklyn Flack. Xingying Guo. Yuchen Liu. Ryan McCluckie. Shewi Chang. Xingrui Qi. Ahmad Sarwar. Yong Yi Tai. Tianhao Chang. In biology with teaching international, Jana Yaha Abdallah Al Hashimi. Mazun Salim Marhun Said Al Kreni. In biomedical science, Jack Allen Cockrell. Phoebe Andrulaki. Kayla Megan Burns. Shannon Doherty. Dylan James Fowler. Georgia Fraser Peters. Andrew Irvin. Pascal Odile Ray. Rimsha Amir. Isha Bhatti. Emily Bocott. Emily Shelby Helen Cameron. Santiago Capazorio Fernandez. Marta Diaz Basanta. Daniel Joseph Lynch. Amy McInnes. Bilal Ahmed Malik. Jenny Amelia McCullough. Rory Rudkin. Amy Van Outen. Callum Wallace. Miko Ryan Turquesa Ariola. Jamie Robert Campbell. Mihak Ijaz. El Leon Ibrahim Diko. Maria Iyaz. Rahim Ikram Mukhtar. Katie Smith. Hassan Usman. Raffle Oduwal. In biomolecular sciences, Erin Masters. In immunology and microbiology, Lottie Louise Aggie Brookhoff. Josh William Fleming. Erin Mills. Duncan Ross Ballantyne. Lee Keenan. Lucian Prokopchich. Sophie Hannah Shearer. In immunology and pharmacology, Lucy Wallace Cummings. Molly Donald. Andrea Ferguson. Maya Louise Kirkwood. Oscar Lavery. Holly Crystal Maguire. Freya Mitchell. Kirsty Lorna Randles. Rimia Binu Tarayu. Artemis Vasyanovich. Anya Volosi. Daniel Cesarius Zawal. Carly Cox. Michael Patrick Dummigan. Hannah Graham. Christopher James Irving. Catherine Ann McNeil. Andrew Middleton. Safa Mohammed. Ana Rita Cardoso Roca de Alameda Pereira. Georgina Riley. Duncan James Doubleday Scott. Daniel Hugh Blount. Freya Jenny Casey. Harry George John Hume. Eve Joyce. Robert McCall. Courtney Grace McManus. Reggie Moore. Divine Chinimerum Wadozi. Abby Margaret Walker. In microbiology and pharmacology, Max Oliver McCallum. Armando Kanga. Sean Sarah McCrory. Fuad Shaji Shurmans. Amy Smith. In biological sciences, Sheikha Suleiman Muhammad Ali Al-Shehi. Helena Jogan. Callum Kerr. Molly Ann Sloan. For the Certificate in Applied Science Skills, Breaking Barriers, Chardonnay Amelia Ann Gray. Lee Scott Kelly. Kieran McNiven. Robert Mitchell. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Science, Willow Demetrio. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Biochemistry and Pharmacology, Ping Yao Chen.
So that was quite exciting. If I'd known I was going to get a selfie on stage, I'd have made sure I'd done my hair. Dignity and respect, please. No laughing at those who've got less hair than others. One thing I should have said before, when I was doing the introduction there, is that we were meant to have an honorary degree presented today as well. I've lost a bit of paper. Anne Johnson. There's another honorary this afternoon, so I'm just trying to make sure I get the right name. So Dame Anne Johnson, unfortunately, was taken ill and was unable to join us today. So we're not presenting an honorary degree to Dame Anne, but she will join us again in our autumn congregations. So apologies for that omission from the start of the programme. First of all, though, let's give a massive round of applause to our new graduates. So well done to everyone. It's been a tough few years for a number of reasons, and I think you can safely say that all of our graduates have shown great resilience, adaptability, and determination to arrive at this day, particularly with these challenges of COVID, the restrictions that we've been living under. So congratulations once again for getting through this and ending up here graduating. And for the first time today, a Faculty of Science graduation ceremony. We're delighted to make awards to a cohort of students who have taken part in the first science version of the trailblazing Breaking Barriers programme. So Breaking Barriers is led by Enable Scotland, an organisation which works with young people who may not otherwise have the opportunity to attend university. The programme supports them in accessing university life, undertaking work experience, and today they graduate with a university qualification from a leading international technological university. The students have studied in all five of our science departments and have also undertaken a placement with Balfour Beattie. So we're delighted to welcome you and your friends and families today. So congratulations. For those of you graduating in the presence of your loved ones, it's undoubtedly a moment of great pride. Your family, friends and supporters have played a crucial part in your journey. Without them, it's very difficult to be a successful student. So students, please applaud your friends and family for supporting you and getting you to this point. And likewise, the dedicated staff that you see on the stage, which may resemble a little bit the Assembly Hall at Hogwarts due to the fine colours and array of colours that are being sported here. You may have understood that blue is the Strathclyde colour for a PhD. There are a variety of different colours indicating the different institutions which our staff and colleagues have gained their degrees from. But they've shown exceptional commitment over the pandemic as well and ensuring that the student experience was as best it could be. So graduates and families, please congratulate our staff and thank them for all the efforts they put into the students. So once we've finished this ceremony, and I promise not to go on too long. I've got Fiona who'll nudge me when I've gone on too long, and I'll stop. We'll leave this hall in an academic procession and we'll head up the hill towards the Teaching and Learning Building, signifying that the graduates are now full members of the Strathclyde academic community, which numbers over 196,000 worldwide. You'll be joining members of our community, such as David Livingston, John Logie Baird, Dame Eilish Angeluni and Sir Tom Hunter, to name but a few. Strathclyde was founded in 1796 during the Scottish Enlightenment through the bequest of Professor John Anderson, who was a leading figure in the Scottish Enlightenment, believing in knowledge for all for the greater good, and he wished to establish a place of useful learning. We have remained faithful to this founding principle, which continues to guide us today as we strive to make a positive impact on society and the world around us. We're a research-intensive institution committed to creating new knowledge and understanding to tackle how to tackle the challenges of our times, and through our groundbreaking research, we're contributing to a better world. And that's not just a self-exaggerated claim we make about ourselves. In the recent Research Excellence Framework in 2021, the UK government system for assessing research quality, almost 90% of Strathclyde's research was assessed as world-leading or internationally excellent. We've also recently just had demonstrated that we have the second highest impact quality profile in Scotland, demonstrating the effect our research has on everyday lives in the real world. We're leading the revitalisation of this part of the city through the Glasgow City Innovation District, which is bringing companies, both large and small, to work together with the university to create new ideas, technologies and solutions to a range of problems across key research clusters. And you may have seen the recent launch of the Scotland Innovation Strategy, which also features clusters not dissimilar to these ones, which are health tech, fintech, 5G, industrial informatics, space and quantum. And much of this is based in our Technology and Innovation Centre on George Street. In the near future, we're going to build another innovation centre named in honour of one of our most successful alumni, businessman Dr. Charles Wang, who donated £50 million to Strathclyde, an extremely generous gift, our largest ever, in recognition of the role that the university played in his success. Part of this gift will be used to support a new sustainable building, a key part in the university's technology and innovation zone, allowing more businesses to co-locate within the university and to improve productivity, develop world-class talent, research and technology, and accelerate inclusive economic growth. We're growing Scotland's manufacturing capabilities as part of the fourth industrial revolution, Industry 4.0, which will see digitalisation, automation and artificial intelligence transform the sector and provide huge economic and employment opportunities. Much of this work is taking place in advanced manufacturing in the Advanced and Manufacturing Innovation District, which is near Glasgow Airport, where the National Manufacturing Institute for Scotland, which will be opened officially tomorrow by the First Minister, is situated. And you may have noticed this if you're ever out at the airport. It's the big maroon purple coloured building with a sawtooth roof. So that's the new National Manufacturing Institute Scotland. It sits alongside the Medicines Manufacturing Innovation Centre, which Strathclyde is also a major player within. We work to inform public policy on national economic strategy, education, productivity and workplace strategies through our various research institutes. For example, through our Centre for Sustainable Development, our globally minded staff and students are working, co-creating solutions with our global partners across academia, civil society and the public and private sectors to secure real world impact and tackle the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. In pursuing our vision, we understand that the value of working successfully in partnership with business, government and the third sector is essential to make a difference. And we extend our global reach through academic partnerships with the likes of Stanford, NYU, MIT, Caltech, Tsinghua, Nanyang Technological University and National University of Singapore, to name but a few. As a university, we are continually working to enhance our student experience, investing in our campus and student experience, as evidenced by our new Strathclyde Sport and learning and teaching buildings, and investing in health and wellbeing services, always putting students at the heart of everything that we do. Our progress and efforts in all of these areas have been greatly recognised in recent years with a host of awards. We became the only university to win the Times Higher Education UK University of the Year twice, first in 2012 and again in 2019. We've also been named Business School of the Year, Workplace of the Year and Research Project of the Year in recent years. Now, this is a graduation from the Faculty of Science, so I'm just going to tell you a few highlights from the Faculty of Science, and in particular from the Institute for Pharmacy and Biomedical Sciences. So research within SIBS is covering a lot of different areas. Dr. Carla Nevis has been awarded a grant to advance research into cardiovascular effects of a novel combination therapy in cancer treatment. Dr. Nati Gomez-Roman has been developing new models of the brain to support the development of new treatments of brain cancers, which includes developing more representative laboratory models of the blood tumour barrier to improve the drug development pipeline for patients with glioblastoma. Improving how our drugs can target the correct site. So Dr. Fiona Murphy is looking at how we can better deliver drugs to the lung by developing physiologically relevant models of the lung. And Professor Hannah Batchelor has established a new facility to develop models of the gastrointestinal tract to improve how medicines taken by the oral route can be improved, with a particular focus on developing age-appropriate medicines for children. And finally, to ensure the development of medicines can be achieved in a sustainable fashion, Dr. Kate Duncan is working on a project on deep ocean resources and biodiscovery, enabling a sustainable and healthy low-carbon future. These examples are just a small sample of the wide-ranging activities and successes from our university in the last year. And it's on these achievements that we build our future. And today is a day for you to look forward to the beginning of a new chapter in your lives, where you'll take the knowledge and skills you've acquired during your time here to pursue and realise your ambitions. As you forge your new careers, the university's values of being ambitious, bold, innovative, collaborative and people-orientated will stand you in good stead. In recent years, the world has been shaken by the coronavirus pandemic, while the cost of living crisis and armed conflict, not least of all the war taking place in our own continent, continue to create uncertainties. And of course, we must tackle our biggest challenge of all, the climate emergency. These challenges demand solutions. And as graduates of Strathclyde and the future leaders of our society, you have a responsibility to use your talents and your education to make a positive impact on the world. Whether you go on to pursue careers in business, science, engineering, politics, any other field, remember you have the power to affect change, to inspire others and to shape the course of history. But with great power comes great responsibility. And I urge you to never lose sight of the values that have guided you so far: integrity, humility, and empathy. These are qualities that will set you aside as you navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. As you step out into the world, you carry with you the knowledge and skills that you've acquired during your time at this esteemed institution, but more than that, you carry the spirit of Strathclyde, a spirit of innovation, collaboration, and excellence. I'm confident that you'll go out into the world equipped with the most valuable asset, knowledge. The Strathclyde degree that you now hold in your hands is your passport to success as you rise to meet the challenges ahead. So as you embark on this new chapter in your lives, I encourage you to continue learning, to embrace new challenges. Remember that the pursuit of knowledge is a lifelong journey and that success is not measured by what you achieve, but by the impact that you make on the world around you. So it's with immense pride that we see you graduate today. And though you may be leaving us, we hope you'll continue to stay in touch and let us know how you get on and continue to contribute to Strathclyde. So in conclusion, I'd like to congratulate you once again on this momentous achievement. The University of Strathclyde has equipped you with the tools you need to thrive in the years ahead, and I have no doubt you will make us proud. So go forth with confidence, with purpose, and with the knowledge you're capable of great things. And I wish you every success for the future.
So in a second, I'll declare this formally closed, but what we're going to do is going to leave the hall as an academic procession, and then we're going to ask the students and the families to follow us up the road to the Teaching and Learning Building for a reception. The weather is looking hot again, so we'll be walking quite slowly. For now, I formally declare this ceremony closed, and please do join us in the reception.